Welcome back to the show. We are at Spectra Salon and Spa. It's too much to show about, but you have it here.
It's a machine.
What's it about?
The machine again. VP lamp.
VP lamp. VP lamp.
What about VPN?
VPN. So this is a VP lamp. And if you come to Spectra Salon and Spa, if your first time to have experience with gel nails, you will definitely have your nails put under the VP lamp. Chekola, ekaza, gel. Yeah. You know, because I kept on asking him, "Kati, what do you chuma chibakola musimuno? Ngachukola muri mugumu kwa kaza jail nangamba eh chino chukola muri mugumu kwa kaza jail." So if you come here, you will definitely have your experience with your nails done. I just love having my nails done here, and it's not even just about kalango. Nego wadiyo zeko musaluni ngosobolo kunyumya negayo no no mugamba na yeyo kala jota deko chitele dekan. Nagamba, I mean, it is just the two of you coming up with something for your nails. It's not a dictation. Ntinzeni now, mugena musaru ni gabai na kala ya jereji. Ngobo ya galwatu ya gala jibagendo kusiga. Obo sasude meka watu sasude jibagendo kusiga. Wogeza kwa kuogera neba kugama kati furumo genono
nye nye ukubila kala woka Spectra.
Because I do everything here and I am glad to be associated with Spectra Salon and Spa. We have a lot. You can choose from all these ones. Exactly, especially this Christmas. Wabo ya gala enjala zozi berenga Christmas trigger kwe fanana. In the mood of celebration, we can do it.
Nabembaga bajao wano, abembaga. Even wedding people, eh?
Mwagala nye bintu byokufumbirwa.
Nze mbaga njagala nnyo. Nalabye muwala wange ono Rema nga ayamba de kitete ekirimu Christmas. Ekyaka yaka.
Nange nze ndowooza nti oba Rema kitete ekyo, never mind. It's December, we're talking about Christmas and it's time to go. Oh, it's time to go.
Maybe say something.
I feel like this is a high and buy. Like no. I would have loved to hear so much from
you. Yeah. But like, I mean, like, what age group are you in? I mean, you don't have to say your age, but what age brackets are you in?
2025.
That 2025, eh? Yes. So, I mean,
2025, your life is just beginning. Let's just let her go.
So, like, for Christmas of 2025, people in your age brackets, like, when you think Christmas, what do you think?
I think going out with the family, mm-hmm. spending time with them, bonding. Yeah, bonding. Yes.
So you see? It's family time.
Yes.
It's doing something special.
Yes.
Bonding with them. That's awesome.
Yeah. You see, I told you guys, yeah, that when Pastor Sempa is here, I do like half the work.
No, you set it up.
So I'm just here doing my nails while he's...
This is my daughter. I've not met her in many years?
You know what? Let's switch things up. It's the end of the year. It's Christmas. Take over.
All right. So listen, it's so good to see you. I really enjoy it. Your dad was such a hero to me. He was the best DJ. Okay? And your mom, she's such a hero. And please tell her I wish her happy Christmas. And I'm hoping that in 2020, we all can catch up. Especially your 2025 generation. And I want to visit your show because she got a radio show. You don't know that? She got
so
radio.
Just told us, never
yeah, ca- I want to come to your radio
just
show.
Kalibambi,
Kalibambi. You know, I'm a judge. This is a season of Bazukulu.
Let her go.
Kali. If you have to go, it's so good to see you. Yeah. Invite me on your show.
She doesn't host people.
A matter of fact, let's take a selfie. Yeah, like look at us. Yeah, I look famous.
No.
God bless you. I hope you have a good show. That you have the rest of the day.
Oh my God! I think we have space for one more guest. If you want, you see, I requested and she allowed. Thank you so much. Guys, Caro is joining us on the show after Banji has left. Caro is CEO, the Madame Boss of Spectra Salon.
Let Caro come and sit close to me. Caro, come and sit here. You tell me about the secret of Spectra. Let her come sit here. See, we see each other like once every year.
Mm-hmm.
You really must increase my frequency here.
I don't know what you mean.
It's like I come here for Christmas, talk about. There's no going to be that new.
Guys, in the mood of Christmas. And my question is very simple. Please go ahead and share with us on our social media. The hashtag is Salon Talk. Is Christmas still a family tradition? And if not, what has changed? What can we do to make it a family tradition? Is it still relevant as a family tradition? Or we can switch things up and say, you know what, this Christmas, I can spend Christmas on my own. My family can spend Christmas on their own, and it is okay.
No. What are you talking about?
Okay, you wait.
You're trying to replace the family?
Is Christmas still a family tradition?
Yes, it is. I believe it's still a family tradition. Most times during Christmas, most churches, they have Christmas carols, different choirs, different worship teams, and people come as a family. During Christmas time, that's when people go to the village to see their family that are in the village. So I believe it's still a family tradition.
Should it remain a family tradition?
It should.
Really? You know the dangers of Christmas remaining a family tradition is that some people will not see their families all year and wait for December. As opposed to if we make the tradition an all year tradition. And I know how Ugandans think, they're like, "Anjabala baku Christmas."
But you have to make money, so you can't see family every day. When will you make the money?
I'm not saying that. Okay, but I know what you mean. So we should just keep Christmas a family tradition.
But really, at the heart of it all, it's not a family tradition.
It is. It has always been.
Because we got people. Simanya binebia omuzungu no webi debebi eruyani. Simanya Santa Claus. Kati wali webi intu ebitu teka webi intu ebitali yu. Simanya Santa Claus. They later Santa Claus. Echisaja chiri au chinebi revu. Then we bring the some folklores from Simanya mbo they are riding reindeers from the elves from where. Kati ebintu ebyo we are really distorting the message of Christmas, which I feel you are saying, let's keep the message of Christmas. The real heart of Christmas is celebrating Jesus Christ. And the best way to celebrate him, you're right, is the context of the family, the context larger of the church, but starts with my heart, my reconnection to honor that person, Jesus Christ. So family or no family, and it can be such a lonely time. You know what I'm saying? When over last year you had someone in your life, and this year they are not there. And it can be really, you know, a difficult time. But at the heart of it is reconnecting with Christ, this great man who solves our issues and who becomes the King of Kings. It's like Coronation Day in Buganda.
Okay, but you can't take away the celebratory, if I may use that word, the celebration, the mood. You can't take that away because never in the history of the world is there a day or a season that is as jovial as Christmas. Yeah, and businesses are benefiting from that.
They do
benefit from that. So, Carol, please help me understand. If we keep Christmas, as Pastor Baba says, we take away Santa Claus. First of all, Santa Claus is, and the whole thing of Christmas, everything we know about Christmas, you will agree with me or you will refuse, is an imported holiday.
Christmas is important.
No, imported.
Imported.
Yes.
I think
it is
true. We're supposed to celebrate Christmas because I do believe that is a time when people have exhausted their mind fast or thanking God for the year.
Go ahead.
Besides actually celebrating Jesus Christ.
Preach it.
It's like you're like, what you're trying to find out, what did I achieve? Where did I fail from? What am I supposed to do in future when the year comes ahead of us? You understand? So Christmas is celebrating and thanking God for keeping you, giving you all that you have. So Santa Claus and everything is just a token of appreciation to God and symbolizing appreciation. That's how I term Christmas for you. And just then getting to your family. You know, we live in a hustle world where you working day and night, some people are abroad. So you just come here to say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, God. what is 2020 going to bring for us? Mm. That's how I term Christmas for me. It's just saying thank you to God.
I like what she says. It's a joyful time. You know what the angel said when Jesus was born? Mm. Joy to the world, the Lord is come. I don't know what you're talking about. Receive a king, let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing.
It's the only moment we give God to thank him and just say thank you, to symbolize how much we appreciate what he has passed us through over the from the first month to the what? To the last month, basically.
Yeah.
Just thanking him and saying, please keep. Giving back to God.
And the fact that Christmas is, those Romans did us good to put it at the end of the year so that you as if reflect on the year. No gambo manyim kama waluwa binji bienpisemu. I have made so many bad decisions na yen chali wo. If there's anything I should be thankful for is the fact that I am still here, so I have another chance to make things better.